So in the previous class we had discussed about the mole concept and the Avogadro number. So now in this class we will discuss few examples from your book, how to solve the examples or how to calculate the number of moles or the find out the particles using the mole or the molecular mass or molar mass. So we will discuss here the examples. So first example I am taking, calculate the number of moles for 52 gram of He, helium. So here we will find out the mole from the mass. Mass is given 52 gram of He, so we have to find out the number of moles. We have to find out the number of moles. So for that we need number of moles, mass is given, and helium mass also we need. So we will write in the following way. So first of all we will take the atomic mass of helium. Atomic mass of helium is 4U. Since it is 4U, so molar mass will be 4G. I had told you in the previous class that only the units will change and the numerical value remains the same, U equal to G. Only when it atomic mass or molecular mass is represented in terms of gram, it's called as molar mass. So atomic mass of helium is 4U. So molar mass is denoted as capital M. So these are very important things, you should remember it. So molar mass is denoted as capital M, and given mass, what is given, that is small m. So molar mass we got 4G, and given mass is given in the question 52 gram. So number of moles, its formula, it is also very important to note down. Number of moles in terms of mass, when masses are given, number of moles, how to find out? No, given mass by molar mass, or small m by capital M. Given mass, small m indicates the given mass, capital M indicates the molar mass. So n equal to small m by capital N, you can solve it, the answer will be 13. So 13 moles. Okay, so now you are clear about this example. Again the question will be given, calculate the number of moles for 12.044 into 10 to the power 23 number of He atoms. So here we will calculate the moles from number of particles. So here the question is given, calculate the number of moles for 12.044 into 10 to the power 23 number of helium atoms. So here we have to find out the mole from the number of particles, and we know that 1 mole equal to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 particles, which is also known as Avogadro number. In the previous class in the mole concept we had already studied 1 mole equal to 6.022. Here we can write 1 mole equal to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 particles, or Avogadro number, which is, this is known as Avogadro number. So we can write Avogadro number also, which is denoted by N0, and the given number of particles which is given in the question, that is capital N, denoted by capital N, 12.044 into 10 to the power 23. So now we will find out the number of moles. So in terms of particles, if the particles are given, then the number of moles, how to find out? Number of moles equal to given number by Avogadro number, given number capital N by Avogadro number N0. So this formula we can use to calculate the number of moles when we will be given to find mole from the number of particles. So now here you learn two things. That is how to find out the number of moles if the masses are given, and how to find out the number of moles if the number of particles are given. So these are very important formulas for you. So you have to learn these formulas. So next example, calculate the mass of 0.5 mole of nitrogen gas. So here we have to find out the mass, and mole is given. So we will find mass from the mole of molecule. So mass we have to find out, but nitrogen gas, molar mass we know that. So we can use the formula as mass equal to molar mass. Molar mass we know that, and the number of moles is given. So I had already told you mass is indicated as small m, molar mass is denoted as capital M, and number of moles is small m. So this is our third number formula. If molar mass and number of moles, if molar mass and number of moles is given, then we can use this formula to find out the mass. So So for nitrogen atomic mass is 14. So for N2 it is 28 U. So gram in gram it is 28 gram. Atomic mass of nitrogen is 28 U. Molar mass of nitrogen is 28 gram. So we can use it and we can find out the mass is 14 gram. Suppose the question is given, calculate the mass of 0.5 mole of N atoms. This question, both the questions are similar, only difference is here N2 gas was given, N2, and here N atoms. Since here it is N2 was there, it was molecule, and here N atoms is given. So the same formula we will use here to find out the mass. So we will use the formula M equal to capital M into number of moles. So here for N2 I was writing 28, but the atomic mass of N is only N is 14. So here also in the question N is given, N2 or N3 is not given, so we will use only 14 and then number of moles, that is 0.5, so that the answer will be 7 gram. Since the difference is here N2, since here 2 was there, so we multiplied 2 in the atomic mass of nitrogen, but here N2 is not given, only N atom. So we will use the atomic mass only for the N atoms, which is 14 gram. So when you will calculate, you will get the mass as 7 gram. The same formula will be used because the question is also same. It is also asking the mass when the number of moles is given. So next example we will take, calculate the mass of 3.011 into 10 to the power 23 number of N atoms. So here number of particles are given. So we will find out the mass from the number of particles. So listen carefully, it is very tricky question. We have to calculate the mass when the number of particles is given. So we know that mass formula is M into N, so we have to find out mass formula, we have to use this formula. So we need mass we are asking to calculate, so for that we need the molar mass and the number of moles. So since nitrogen atoms is given, we know the nitrogen molar mass is 14. For nitrogen the molar mass is 14 into number of moles we don't have. So we need the number of moles to calculate the mass. So we know the molar mass of nitrogen, only nitrogen atom is given, so we will use the 14. Since atomic mass of only nitrogen atom is 14, so molar mass will be also 14. So now here 14 into, we know the formula of calculating number of moles when particles are given. I had told you in the previous example, if the number of particles are given, then to find out the number of moles, we will use given number of particles by Avogadro number. Given number of particles by Avogadro number. So now we can use the given number of particles, that is 3.011 into 10 to the power 23 by Avogadro number is 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. So you can calculate it and then you can get the 14 into 0.5, that is 7 gram. So this is how the mass is calculated when numbers are given. So first of all, we have to find out the number of moles, because to calculate the mass, the formula is M equal to mass equal to molar mass into number of moles. And here number of moles is not given. Instead of number of moles, number of particles are given. So we will use the another formula to find out number of moles, that is given number of particles by Avogadro number, and then we can get the mass. So here also you see the same question is given, calculate the mass of 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 number of N2 molecules. So here also we have to calculate the mass from the number of particles. It is similar to as the previous question, but the only difference is here N2 molecules is given and here it was N atom. Here it was N atom and here it is given N2 molecules. So we know the formula for calculating the mass, that is mass equal to molar mass into number of moles. So for N2, for N the atomic mass is 14. So molar mass is also 14 gram. So for N2, atomic mass is 14 into 2. N2 means here we will multiply 2, so we will get 28. So the molar mass will be 28 gram. So we will use here 28 into number of moles. We have number of particles. So how to find out the number of moles? Again the same formula we will use, given number of particles by Avogadro number. Number of moles means given number of particles by Avogadro number. So given number of particles is our 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. In the question it is given number of particles, and Avogadro number we know, that is 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Avogadro number is fixed for all. So this is our given number which is given in the question N, and this is our Avogadro number, so we can solve it. We will get 1. So this is our number of moles. So this is our number of moles. By solving we can get the mass. So now I think you are clear how to calculate the mass if the number of particles are given. So now you have to practice all these things in your copy. I will check all of your copy. So practice, do all these examples in your copy. Next example we will discuss in the next class.